Hi, welcome back to Engineering Stories. As you can see, I am in a different place than usual. I am back home for the holidays. I finished all my exams. For a lot of you right now who are applying to post-secondary or who maybe are trying to transfer into a different post-secondary than they are in currently, I'm sure this is a very busy time for you. There are so many schools to look at, and each school has their own different way of doing things. So today I am going to break down all the basics about the UBC admission process and just give you everything you need to know or point you in the direction of other things that you need to know that I can't cover in this video. The first thing that's different about a UBC application is that they don't just look at your grades. For UBC, they also look at a personal profile. So a personal profile is something you write. They ask you questions and you answer them in around like 200, 500 words. And they just use this to sort of get a better understanding about who you are as a person, what you're passionate about, what you're interested in, because UBC recognizes that you are more than just a number. Everyone who is from high school needs to write a personal profile. With different programs, they have to answer more or less questions. There's a link online that I'll link you to that shows all of the personal profile questions that you could be asked. I think for engineering, you have to answer about 5 of them, but for other programs, you could have to answer all of them. So it's good to just take a look and know what you could be asked on your personal profile. So who reads the personal profile? The professors who volunteer to read and the UBC alumni who volunteer to read will be reading your personal profiles. They have been trained to read and compare personal profiles and pick out the things that they want. So the first thing they're looking for is engagement and accomplishment. They want to know what you do when you're outside of class. Do you contribute to a club? Do you volunteer? Do you look after your sibling? Have you won some competition for something? They just want to see what you do when you're not in school. They also look for leadership. They just want to see how you have demonstrated your responsibility, how you've taken over as captain or treasurer of your, I don't know, swim team. I don't think swim teams have treasurers, but you know what I mean. If you show that you can lead people and you have a strong personality that people like to follow, they really like that. Also with leadership, they want to learn, or they want to know what you have learned from your experiences. Like if you've led something, they don't care just that you've led it, they want to know what you learned from that, what you took away from that experience. Another thing they watch out for is substance. They want to know that you have taken the time to actually come up with a good personal profile. It needs to be a good reflection of who you are as a person and just something that you should be proud of. The last thing they look for is voice. They want to see that your personal profile reflects you as a person. Is it unique? Is there something that's different from another personal profile? You know, if all the personal profiles read the same really bland, professional way, then they're not really gonna get to know you as a person. Basically, the takeaway from this is they want, here, this rhymes, this is really nice, reflective, introspective, and change in perspective. So that means if you did something, don't just write about what you did, you need to write about how it changed you, how it changed your perspective. If you were to encounter the same problem again, what would you do differently? You know, they want to see what you've taken away from the experience rather than just what the experience was. And that's the main thing that you should focus on. Some tips and tricks are to not discount your extracurriculars. So that means if you haven't had time to volunteer, let's say, because you've been looking after your family, just write about that. Honestly, it doesn't need to be like volunteering or you're captain of a club. Just write about what you're doing that's taking your time and how you're contributing to whatever it is. Anything that you do, just write about it. Don't discount anything. Another thing I would really suggest is start your personal profile early. Don't start it a week before it's due. Start it early and then just keep coming back to it. See if there's anything that you forgot to add, anything you want to change or tweak. I would really suggest doing it in a different document. Don't answer all the questions directly onto the personal profile. Maybe answer them in a Google Docs or a Word document and then just copy and paste them after. That way you can spell check them, grammar check them, make sure everything's good, double check everything before you submit it. I highly recommend that. I think that was really helpful for me. Okay, now we are going to move on to grades and courses. So Grades, I know, scary for a lot of people. They were definitely scary for me. But take a deep breath, relax. You should be fine. What courses do you need? I'm going to just talk about Canadian students because it's different for every country. You need to graduate from high school, one. You should get minimum of 70% in grade 11 and 12 English. And then you're recommended at least 6 grade 12 courses before you graduate. There are other specific requirements. Again, those can be looked at online. I'm just gonna talk about the engineering degree requirements because this is engineering stories. So in grade 12 for engineering, you need English Studies 12 or English First People 12. You need Pre-Calculus 12, although it is recommended that you have Calculus 12. I didn't have Calculus 12 and it was very rough for me. So if you can get Calculus 12, you should definitely try to. You need Chemistry 12 and Physics 12. But again, if you don't have this, it's not end of the world. You're still recommended to apply, but you just might have to go through a different stream than other people. For grade 11, for the engineering degree program, you need any English Arts 11 or any English First Peoples 11. You need a Language 11 or waiver. You also need Pre-Calculus or Foundations of Mathematics 12. And then you also need Chemistry 11 and Physics 11. UBC has a master list of all the schools around the area, so they know what your school does and doesn't offer. So, like, it's easier to get in if you've taken AP and IB courses because it shows that you are very vigorous with your studies and you like to pressure yourself. But if your school doesn't offer these courses, I know my school only offered 2 AP courses, then don't worry about it. UBC knows what is available to you and what isn't. So just, like, try your hardest, but if it's just impossible to take certain courses, then don't worry. UBC knows and they are able to evaluate you for your school. So what grades does UBC look at when they're looking at my grades? They look at 2 different averages. They look at the grades in all your academic courses. So this will be courses like math, sciences, English, foreign language, social studies, not things like gym or woodwork. So they're gonna take your average for all your academic courses, and then they're also gonna look at an average for your degree-specific courses. So for engineering, this includes language arts, mathematics and computation, and sciences. So they won't be looking at your social studies for engineering, for example, but they will look at your social studies in your overall academic courses average. So references, you're gonna have to link, I think it's 2 people as your references. They can't be friends or family members. I used like my piano teacher and my physics teacher, for example. Your references will not be contacted unless they need additional information. UBC needs additional information on you. If there was something unclear in your personal profile, then yeah, they might contact your references, but for the most part, your references probably won't be contacted. They're not contacting every single reference. So why should you choose UBC? Well, UBC was ranked 2nd best post-secondary school in Canada. Also, UBC is 2nd best in engineering in Canada. Another thing that people like about UBC engineering is that you get to go into a first year that is general and then pick your major after 2nd year. I know for a lot of people coming from grade 12, or I know when I was in grade 12 at least, I didn't really know what I wanted to do. I knew I wanted to go into engineering, but I still don't. And I didn't know what kind of engineering. And that's what's really nice about UBC is that they have a foundational first year where you can take all the general courses and they teach you about all the different disciplines. You learn about all of the different types of engineering, and then that way you're ready to apply for 2nd year. And that way you don't like start a degree that you don't like and then it turns out you like another type of engineering more, then you have to switch, it's such a hassle. So I hope that this was helpful for you. If you need any more information or you have any questions, just comment down below. I'm going to be putting the links to all the places where I found this information online and the links to places you can go to get additional information for program specifics if you're not going into engineering or you just want to like make sure you have absolutely everything you need to know. I'll put that all in the description. Good luck on all your applications. I hope you get into the school you want to get into. Make sure you start your personal profile early and have a great day. Bye!